Understanding these two things within my business took me from this to this at 19 years old, and now I'm here in Miami with some of my clients, mentors, killers in the industry, and that are doing 50k moms, 100k moms, and these two things, the only two things which you're not thinking about right now, you're overthinking, you're thinking it's your email, and you're thinking it's your logo, and you're thinking it's your company branding, and all this stuff that doesn't actually matter. These two things I'm going to reveal took me from at 17 just working a 9-to-5 sales job, hating my life, wanting to do an online business and travel the world like I'm currently doing, do 40K a month at 19 years old. I now just turned 20. That's why we're actually here in Miami. Kind of celebrating my 20th birthday, but obviously meeting up with clients, meeting up with mentors and all this kind of stuff, okay? Now, before I reveal the two things, that the only two things that you need to do, and of course, there's a few people watching this video that will click off and, you know, you're getting a little bit of dopamine already. Maybe in the sidebar, there's like a how to sign clients with email and all this kind of shit, right? But if you understand these two things, trust me, none of that will actually matter, okay? Now, the first thing you need to understand is your skill, okay? Now, I know that's incredibly boring, and I know that you wanna hear the new fancy offer and all this kind of stuff, but you do need to understand that in this game, you're not a global e-commerce brand, right? You're either an agency owner or you're an online coach, probably watching my channel, right? Meaning all you're trying to optimize for is to provide the most value possible for like 15 to 30 people, maybe even less. You don't need to sign a lot of clients to hit 30K months, 50K months, 100K months, right? Whereas in a business model like e-commerce or whatever, you're obviously serving the mass global market of, you know, thousands, 10,000s of people, right? Meaning all you really need to focus on is providing an incredible service and getting an incredible reputation. The reason why you're struggling to sign clients and hit these months is just because of your reputation and your service, right? Does anyone actually vouch for you? Okay, like, do you have any skill within the industry? For example, even last night I was at a cigar lounge and two guys are doing decent numbers. I think one of them's doing like 60k a month, the other's doing like 16 to 20k a month, but he's definitely on a come up. They needed appointment setters. Now, at my company, mobileclients.io, obviously we've mastered appointment setting teams, SOPs, workflows, all that kind of stuff. And I just said to them, like, hey, like, let's jump on a call sometimes this week when we all get back. And yeah, we can place appointment setters for you. I got their WhatsApp, and that's probably gonna turn into maybe, I don't know, 5 to 6K cash for my business, right? Why? Because I have a reputation, I have a skill. There's people around me that vouch for me and will pay me money, okay? That is in the game, that is the game that you are in, okay? So understanding that, because you're probably sitting there, you're thinking, oh wait, but like, look, I'm not in Miami, I'm not at a cigar lounge with 60K a month entrepreneurs, I can just picture my selling service and provide them a ton of value, and they're gonna fucking kill it with that as well, which is awesome. So what do I actually do? Well, first of all, it's about building that, right? Now, if you have a look at my channel, I think 2 years ago, yeah, around, well, no, 1.5 years ago, maybe, I started off my skill in content creation. So I had about 10 to 12 clients. One of them was actually my first ever client in the content space, Nathan Vaisberg, who's now a mentor. You know, we've been hanging out with him all week in Miami, which is just unreal. Like, my first ever client when I was 17. Now I'm just like, that's my boy. You know, it's weird how it kind of comes full circle. And I started off providing content services and providing value that way, right? Then I started slowly kind of learning appointment setting systems and became very, very good at placing setters and booking appointments for people and coming up with kind of like acquisition workflows, email sequences, and all that kind of like conversion stuff, okay? So I decided to niche what I was doing into that vertical and that skill, okay? Now, a lot of you right now, the issue is you don't have that thing that you're niche in, okay? Because imagine that cigar lounge that I was at, imagine if I said, oh guys, yeah, I can help you with setters, but my thing's also content. They wouldn't have believed me as much, right? It wouldn't have been as powerful. Because I have a skill in a certain sector, which is just client acquisition, the middle of funnel, okay? People are gonna pay me money because it's a skill and I'm niche to that skill. So you need to figure out what your thing is before you start, you know, stressing that you're not making money. Obviously you're not making money. What are people gonna pay you for? What would you pay you for? That's a good question to ask yourself. What would you pay you for? If you were genuinely in my shoes, if, for example, if you were in my shoes, okay? And if you were standing in front of me right now and here in beautiful Brickell, Miami, okay? And I said, hey, you know, I wanna pay you for a service. What would you actually pay? Like, what would you actually think I could pay you for? And if you can't answer that question, then that's your first problem within your business. Okay, it's not, oh, your offer, it's not, oh, all this kind of stuff. And this is that's important, of course. But that cigar lounge kind of like analogy is a perfect analogy. Imagine if I said, oh yeah, guys, you know, I'm good at setters, but I'm also good at this and that and that, and I specialize in all these fields. No, I'm good at conversion, okay? So I got the WhatsApp and it's gonna go from there. That's a good analogy, okay? Now, the second thing, so once you understand that, your skill level, this took me from, this, like always niching down in a thing, in a certain vertical, will get you referrals, okay? We'll do all this kind of stuff. It will explode your business, trust me. That's something to write down, okay? And whether it's AI, whether it's appointment setting, whether it's conversion. Now, at mobilefly.io, we do a lot of stuff now just because we bring on, you know, mentors and all that kind of stuff. We're big on paid ads, etc. But you advance your skills, right? So whether your thing's AI, whether your thing's like organic content, right? Like, one of the guys I was with, the cigar lounge last night, you know, his thing's organic, right? Imagine if he started being like the organic guy and the setting guy and the ad guy. Like, it wouldn't work. Nathan is ads, right? Like, he's very, very good at paid ads. Imagine if he was like, oh, now I'm like the organic content king and the paid ads king. No, it just wouldn't work, okay? Because there's too many people. Look how many competitors there are. Look how many competitors are on the sidebar right now, right? It's crazy, okay? Now, the second thing is traffic. Okay, look at your business right now. Please analyze all the data, okay? Because I have data from all my traffic sources, okay? It's something I need to work on as well, right? Where is your traffic? How are people knowing about your product? Who the fuck is gonna buy from you? Okay, now a lot of you are like, well, wait, what do you mean like traffic? Like I send cold DMs and this kind of stuff. Like, that's your issue. Now, I'm not saying that cold DMs are bad. I place appointments and teams for agencies, for consultants, for service providers. Our cold outbound fucking crushes. But it isn't scalable traffic. And even if you're doing it, are you doing it right? Do you have the right scripts? Do you sell prospects correctly? Do you have the right workflows, the SOPs, the daily reports? Okay, look at the traffic within your business. And then it'll be very evident why you're stuck below 10K a month, okay? Because if you have a product, and no one knows about your products, you're cooked, especially in this industry, right? We are an extremely creator-led industry, more than we were in 2 years ago, right? I've been in this industry for like 2 years now. When I was starting, it was an extremely creator-led industry. That's why I started posting YouTube content and documenting my journey at 17 years old. I'm now just turned 20, right? So you can see when I was like squeaky as fuck, like all this kind of shit, right? It's a creator-led economy. And most YouTubers won't tell you that because they'll be like, oh, no, guys, like definitely don't post content even though I'm posting content. But I'm posting content and I'm telling you guys, like, yeah, it's important, okay? Because not even just because to be a YouTuber, not even just to be famous. Some of you don't want to be famous, okay? That's fine. But you need traffic. You need people viewing your offer. You need people, you know, seeing what you have to present, funnels, etc. Okay, some of you are like, oh, Luke, I crafted up a VSL. If you guys know what a VSL is, right? And oh, it's not working. What? Five people have viewed it. So how is this ever gonna make money, right? Now you can do this through various different things. You can do this through cold outbound, mass cold outreach. You can do it through paid advertising, which we're tapping into now at scale. You can do it for YouTube videos like this, right? But whatever you do, if you want to make serious money, you will need growth in viewership. You will need an audience, okay? Now, this isn't rocket science. If you look at anyone that's making a ton of money right now, this is exactly how they're doing it, okay? And this is why your business is stuck. This is why you can't scale, okay? This is why you're not getting results like my clients are getting. I'll put up a ton of results here through leveraging different cold outbound systems, paid out systems, because I have insight, right? Number three is kind of network, right? Because the insight you get is just different level. You know, many people don't, when you're talking in real life, it's different from maybe a YouTube video. People hold things back or whatever, but you know, when you actually meet people, you understand the plays that are going to be made 7 days, weeks, months out, and you can kind of like position yourself beforehand to obviously capitalize, okay? So very, very quick video. I just want to reveal the two things that took me from 0 to 40K a month at 19. and help my clients get a ton of incredible results. You can have a look at my Instagram and all that kind of stuff as well. Doing various different things, etc. Right? It's literally your niche of skill and like helping people, okay, becoming an authority in that vertical, because you can actually get incredible fucking results, whatever it is. And the second is traffic, okay? If you don't have something that can actually help people and you do not have traffic, you are literally never going to make money. It isn't a thing of like, oh, wait a year, grind it out. It isn't a thing of like, oh, you know, manifesting, my time's gonna come, all this kind of shit is cool. But at the end of the day, if you don't have those two things, forget about it, okay? If you're never gonna have a skill, I'm never gonna pay you, okay? You know, so leave it as is. If you are ready to get dialed in and actually start building a skill, building a high ticket offer, which is incredibly important. You need to be offering value to business owners, especially in this era where there's a ton of freelancers. You're probably being cooked in the market right now, and you want to dial in with setters and ads, then book a call with the description below. And or you can watch the VSL where you can just learn a little bit more about what I do and all that kind of stuff as well. But I hope that provides you a ton of value. Hope that provides you a ton of insight, and keep killing it, man, because this game can just be like, it can change your entire life. Being able to just be here in the middle of October in Miami, meeting people. We had a dinner on the first night we got here. It was jet lagged as fuck. I was like 21 hours from London, which was an incredible dinner with my clients, with Nick Law, with James, with Nathan, with my business partner, Harvey. And yeah, then we went to Cigar Lounge that one night, and then I can't remember what we did. It feels like I've been there for a while. But traveling the world and everything is just incredible. So hope you enjoy the video. And if you want more clarity on how to do this, you can check out this video here or somewhere around here, and it'll show you. So see you soon.